Hello family, so thankful you took the time to watch this video, and I just want to say thank you guys for partnering with us, praying for us, thinking about us. It's so encouraging to know that we are in this fight, in this work together, and even though we are thousands of miles apart, I believe that we have one heart and one mind, which is to make Christ known and to share his love with the world. And I just wanted to use this video just to kind of give you guys a summary of what God did through your support and through your prayers and through your partnership over last year. And also some plans that we have for this year as well. And again, it's a team sport. You know, doing ministry is a team effort. We're the body of Christ, and the Lord kept reminding me again and again, it's not a one-man show. It's a body thing. And so I just want to say thank you so much. Even as I was looking through the letters of Paul, we see him constantly giving thanks for different people that partner with him in the ministry. And they were very, very important to him. And in the same way, your love, your support, your giving is really touches my heart and lets me know that what we're doing is from God, because God always supplies and supports the work that he initiates, and your regular support and your help and your messages is just a testament of God's faithfulness in our work here. And it just keeps, I always have this sense like the Lord is behind us all the way, and we've seen him do many miracles through our life here. And again, thank you so much for your partnership.
Pinch me on my face.
Oh, say hello, Akari.
Dad, pinch me on my face.
Pinch me on your face? Why don't you talk to mom about that?
Dad, pinch me all the time on my face.
1 second. Anyways. Okay, so last year, thanks to your help, your partnership, we freed about 9 families. I was hoping for 10. 9 was awesome. And I believe that the coming years we'll be able to free more families and get them out of the brick kiln. So awesome. Praise the Lord for that. So 9 families, that's many lives being impacted through your giving and through your sponsorship. So awesome. And also we have 5 children as well that are staying with us. And I can tell you the 5 kids that we've had is a lot of work. It's a lot of work. And we need more physical hands. So please keep that in prayer that we get more helpers as we take in more kids, because I can tell you, it's not easy. They're coming from different backgrounds, trauma, lack of discipline. So yeah, so 5 children, they're doing much better now. And yeah, so I think we're able to get in more kids as long as we have one more helper that will come and join our house. So I hope for this year we're able to get another helper for the home, because there's many kids that really need a loving home. It's very difficult. And yeah, we have the space now. Like, God gave us a beautiful house, a new house. And also God has added on to us more sponsors. So Eden Tree Church has partnered with us this past year. And their support is helping us to manage this house, to pay the rent, and to take care of this home. So many blessings to them. And we have Pathway is also sponsoring us for this coming year as well. So that's awesome. And then we have a New Life Church from Norway. They've sent us generous donations as of last year, and to help the needy, to clothe people, to help people start small businesses, and to support the children's home. So that's awesome. I love seeing the body of Christ coming together, and it's amazing how the Lord puts us on people's hearts, and they reach out to us and they want to partner with us. And so we really appreciate all your partnerships and all of you individual, you're all the individual donors as well. You're not forgotten. There's tremendous reward for you for sowing into our ministry, because you are impacting many people's lives, and the Pakistani church is mostly forgotten, but you're remembering them, and I'm so thankful to be a channel of blessing that your help goes through me to them. And so also on the behalf of my family here, my father-in-law, mother-in-law, and our church members, thank you so much for your help and your partnership. And you are in our heart and in our prayers. So we do pray for all the sponsors and for your church and your families. And yeah, so thank you so much. This year, yeah, so 9 families free, 5 children in our home. We got a new house. Also this year, we were able to put on multiple crusades with Pastor Marcel coming from Cameroon. And those were pretty awesome. Many people got deliverance and healing and salvation. So praise the Lord for that. And this leads me for the next year. I just really, really, really want to establish an outdoor presence regularly in the city where any passerby can come and hear the gospel on a weekly basis, on a weekday, and receive their deliverance, their healing, they hear the gospel, people are being fed. So that's my vision for 2022, that we have a year of touching our community. When the Holy Spirit fell on the day of Pentecost, the disciples, they went outside and preached the gospel. They were outside demonstrating the power of Jesus Christ. So we really want to have this outdoor witness established this year. So please, keep this in your prayers, that we get all the money for the equipment. It would be awesome to partner with a church that would really help us with this part, to make sure that we have a financial support for the outdoor meetings. Like, this is something really on my heart. Every time we have outdoor meetings, the power of God comes down, the atmosphere is supercharged. Like, we just need to have this outlet on a regular basis. Like, many people need hope. And as the Bible tells us, you know, there's different gifts and different ministry gifts. And like, we have a blessing of laying hands on the sick and seeing people get delivered and preaching the gospel with power and signs like following. So we really want to be active out in the community and have a safe place where people can come, especially non-believers like Muslims, because usually they will not come to a church, but in an outdoor meeting like this, they may just pop in and come for prayer. And in the outdoor meetings, there's always Muslims that come to these meetings to receive prayer. And so we really want to have an outdoor presence outside. And we have a team within our church. We're trained to do security, to do ushering, to do worship, to do all these things. We just need the financial support to be outside, because it's not cheap to buy the equipment. We want to buy our own, because renting every single month will cost a lot of money. And but if we buy our own, we're able to really save those costs. So please, really try to connect with somebody, even on our behalf. Say, hey, there's some people in Pakistan, they really want to be outdoors to minister to people. Consider partnering with them to set them up so they can preach the gospel to the public. That would be awesome. I'd be really, really hoping for that. As of last year, we had more than 40 baptisms from this church plant here in Yohannesburg and also in Shree Park, like more than 40 baptisms last year. So praise the Lord for that. We finished the Experiencing God course together as a leadership team. And because of Experiencing God, we have regular prayer meetings in our house now to hear from God together with the kids and our ministry leaders and our partners, to hear God, what he wants us to do. Praise the Lord. In the book of letters, Titus chapter 2, you know, Paul is telling us the reason why we are saved and what Christ wants us to do. It says here in Titus chapter 2, verse 14, Jesus, who gave himself up for us to redeem us from all lawlessness and to purify for himself a people for his own possession, who are zealous for good works. So Christ wants us to be zealous for good works. In 2022, I declared that this is a year of bearing much fruit, supporting our community, buying out more slaves, taking in more children, clothing the naked, feeding the hungry. We are going to be zealous for good works. And we're believing the hand of God is going to move upon our life, because when you pour yourself out for the needy and the hungry and the broken. The Lord will do miracles in our lives. And so I told the church, you know, I want this year to be a year of giving, a year of serving. It is a year of bearing much spiritual fruit. So I just want to continue to encourage you, you know, continue to sow sacrificially into whatever ministry that you're a part of, who are going out and blessing their community, touching the needy, clothing the naked, preaching the gospel. Like, it's time to really use our time, use our finances for the promotion of the gospel and spreading the love of Christ through this world. Time is very short. The atmosphere is changing. The spiritual atmosphere is definitely changing. The world can recognize that. And so this is an opportunity for us as a church to shine the light of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So the outdoor meetings, feeding the hungry, clothing, buying people out of the brick kiln, that's something we're going to continue to do in 2022, taking more children for the glory of God, and to make disciples. Everything, always the foundation is to make disciples through that service, through that love. So thank you guys so much for your partnership, and may 2022 be fruitful for us and also fruitful for you. God wants to use you where you are. Align yourself to Him. He will make a way for you. He'll use you powerfully. And, you know, every one of us is called to be a world changer. Every person that's in Christ is called to impact this world, to change this world for the better, right? So I just want to leave you with that. Continue to pray for us, and so that we're able to really shine the light of Christ in these dark days. Here, many deaths are happening. Young people are dying. My grandfather my wife's grandfather just passed away right before the new year. And so we had his funeral service, but what's good for him is he had the fruits of Christ. So preaching his funeral was a real blessing. But yeah, people are dying, and we need to get the gospel out there and prayer and get the people ready for the coming of Jesus Christ. So thank you again for your partnership. It means a lot. It's a huge deal that you are helping us. And may you continue to partner with us for the coming year, and may we bear much fruit together. And I think that's about it. My kids are doing fine. Kids are doing well. We're looking forward for this year. We know the challenges are going to come, but we know the hand behind us is powerful. So we look to Jesus Christ, the author and perfecter of our faith. So God bless you. Keep us in your prayers. And yes, keep in touch. Email me with any questions. I have a request. I have a website for our children's home and for the Brick Hill ministry. And on that website is a coloring book. And if you could download that coloring book, have your child color it, or you can color it, take a picture of you holding it and send it to us so we could put it on the wall so that the kids can see who's praying for them and who's caring for them. So yeah, so please go to the website, download the coloring book. If you want to donate on the website, everything is set up now. You can use a credit card, a debit card as well. You can give a small donation if you're led. And all that will go towards supporting the Brick Hill work and the kids here. So, yeah. And so when you finish the picture, send it to us and we'll put it on the wall. And we're hoping that people from all over the world will download the coloring book and send us the photos of the completed art so that the kids can see that people around the world are really caring for them and praying for them. So, yeah. So, love you guys. Take care. Have a wonderful day.